Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning. Okay, so for today we are going to finish 10.2. Okay, so you already learned 10.1, the characteristics of sound wave. Okay, such as sounds this medium to travel, and for example, sounds propagate faster in solid compared with liquid and gases. So in 10.2, you are going to learn about the loudness and pitch of sound. Okay, so these are two different things. Okay, loudness and pitch are two different things. Okay. So loudness depends on the amplitude. Okay, so we are going to look at what is the definition for amplitude, and the unit for amplitude is in meter, usually in meter M. Pitch, okay, depends on the frequency, and the unit is hertz or Hz. Okay. So what is the definition for amplitude? Okay, amplitude is the maximum distance from the equilibrium point, and frequency is the complete number of wave produced within a second. Maksudnya frequency ni adalah satu kitaran gelombang yang dihasilkan dalam masa satu saat. Okey, manakala amplitude ni adalah jarak maksimum, jarak yang paling tinggi daripada equilibrium point, tu selalunya kosong lah. Okey, so kita akan tengok dalam bentuk graf nanti. Okey, amplitude A is the maximum distance from the equilibrium. Amplitude is measured in meter or centimeter. Pitch of the sounds depends on the frequency. Okay, remember the definition for frequency is how many completed cycle of the sound wave in 1 second, and the unit in hertz. Okay, capital H and small z. Okay, so this is based on your textbook. So this is the graph of amplitude over time. So you can see on the x-axis is the time, and the y-axis is the amplitude. Okay, so this is the amplitude, the distance between the paksi X and paksi Y. Okay, yang vertical ni, yang secara menegak ni, selalunya menunjukkan amplitude. Okay, jadi kita boleh tengok kat sini amplitude dia adalah satu lah. Okay, manakala frekuensi adalah satu kitaran gelombang yang lengkap. Okey, satu. Okey, mesti dia ada atas dan bawah. Barulah ini dikira sebagai satu kitaran gelombang yang lengkap. Okey, tapi benda yang perlu kamu ingat, okey, adalah konsep di sebelah kanan buku teks ni. So if the wave amplitude increases, so louder sound is produced. Maksudnya, kalau kamu tengok di sebelah kiri, amplitude dia adalah satu, tapi apabila kita tingkatkan amplitude kepada dua, jadi bunyi yang dihasilkan adalah lebih kuat. Okay. Dan yang seterusnya, okay, wave frequency increases and higher pitch of sound is produced. Okay, jadi maksudnya kalau kamu tengok on the left, okay, okay, there are not so many complete sound wave. Okay, if they are the closer the distance between the sound wave cycle, okay, so lagi dekat jarak antara gelombang tersebut, satu kitaran gelombang, jadi bunyi yang dihasilkan lebih nyaring, okay, lebih nyaring, okay, pitch tu berkaitan dengan nyaring lah, okay, higher pitch of sound is produced. So number six, musical instruments that can produce notes with a wide frequency range and pitch. Okay, so these are some examples of musical instruments that can produce, okay, a variety of frequency range and pitch. Okay, you have piano, guitar, violin, and drum. Okay, the changes in frequency can be changed by altering the thickness of string. Okay, the thicker the string. Okay, if you have a guitar at your home, you can see that if the string of the guitar is thicker, so the lower pitch of sound will be produced. Okay. And the tension, okay, regang, tension of the string, keregangan tali tersebut. If the tension of the string is greater, the pitch of the sound of this, so sorry, if the tension of the string is higher, the greater the pitch of the sound produced. So in this one, you can just simply take a rubber band and try to stress it, okay, stretch it. So if you stretch it further, so the sound produced will be high pitch compared with the rubber band that has a less stretching, okay. And the length of the string, okay, the shorter the string, the higher the pitch of the sound produced, okay. Okay, next we are going to look at what is Doppler effect. Okay, Doppler effect is the apparent change in frequency. So you must remember the word apparent change in frequency. So there are four words. What? In the definition for Doppler effect, caused by relative movement of sound source, the relative movement of the observer or both. Okay, so as you can see on the left, if the ambulance siren, okay, is closer to the observer, you can see the frequency is increases. But if the ambulance is far away from the observer, okay, the frequency will be decreases. So that is the Doppler effect. Maksudnya perubahan frekuensi disebabkan berubahnya kedudukan sumber bunyi atau sumber bunyi tersebut ataupun berubahnya kedudukan orang yang dengar bunyi tersebut. Okey, itulah maksudnya Doppler effect. Okay, this is the same thing that I explained just now. Okay, as the ambulance approach the observer, the frequency of the siren increases. Okay, and the pitch increases. So when the frequency increase, pitch will increase. simple correlation. As the ambulance moved away from the observer, the frequency of the siren will decrease, so resulting in the pitch heard by the observer will be decreases. Okay, that's all for today. Okay, and the last subtopic 10.3 will be covered in the next session. Thank you for listening.